Happy Sunday Funday, y'all. It's your boy X-Men 1991 coming to you back again with another anniversary rant. But before I get into that, here to give you my quick halftime report on today's NFL opening season between my Houston Texans and the Indianapolis Colts. Texans gave up a touchdown in the first quarter while kicking two field goals. But they made a comeback in the second quarter, outscoring the Colts 6-0. At halftime, Texans 12, Colts 7. Not too bad for the first half, but let's see what's going to happen in the second half. So my recap of this game is coming tomorrow. But today has been 30 years. Hear me, 30 years since one of the best cop drama shows premiered on Fox. New York Undercover, September 8th, 1994, New York Undercover premiered on Fox. It follows the series of two detectives, Detective J.C. Williams and Detective Eddie Torres, played by Malik Yoba and Michael DiLorenzo. Of course, New York Undercover was co-created by Dick Wolf, and the storyline took place in the same fictional universe as Law and Order and its spinoffs, The Chicago and FBI, and Homicide: Life on the Street. This show, along with Martin and Living Single, dominated Fox's Thursday night lineup, withdrawing millions of viewers like myself away from NBC's must-see TV Thursday night lineup. Even though NBC's must-see TV Thursday night lineup was great, but it couldn't beat Fox's Thursday night lineup. Fox's Thursday Night Live, they had Martin, Living Single, and New York Undercover. New York Undercover ran for four seasons and 89 episodes, from September 8th, 1994 to February 11th, 1999. Although I stopped watching New York Undercover after season three because they killed off Detective Torres' character. And that's, in my opinion, what caused the show to go downhill. And also, this was a little controversy back in 1996. On July 23rd, on that year, 1996, the day shooting was supposed to begin on the third season. Malik Yoba and Michael DiLorenzo didn't show up. Having joined together and presenting a list of demands to creator/producer Dick Wolf, both actors wanted their pay increase. DiLorenzo stated that the duo were making $40,000 each per episode and wanted $100,000 each per episode. They also wanted more creative input, with DiLorenzo in particular wanted to direct a few episodes. They wanted a gym trailers for the stars and better food to be provided on set. Wow. After receiving their demands, Dick Wolf declined and said that New York Undercover was not Friends. Wolf was irate, calling the demands of actors joining together to hold a show in limbo a virus to the entertainment industry, and he threatened to write both Malik Yoba and Michael DiLorenzo out of the show altogether. A day after the holdout, Universal Television, which was the production company of the show, filed a $1.2 million lawsuit against Yoba and DiLorenzo, claiming that the two had breached their contract and claimed that they were costing the show $60,000 each day they didn't show up to work. After 3 days, the holdout ended, and the two actors returned back to set with their demands unmet and continued under the terms of their original contract. However, tensions lingered between Michael DiLorenzo and Dick Wolf, and towards the end of season three, they killed off Detective Torres's character. Malik Yoba was retained on the show for its fourth and final season. Even though I stopped watching New York Undercover after season three, the show was still good. It's a top three Fox show of all time. If you remember watching my top 20 Fox shows video, I put New York Undercover in the top three because it dominated Fox's Thursday night lineup with Martin and Living Single. New York Undercover is still a great show. Surprising that it's now 30 years old. Actually, Fox was killing it in 1994. South Central premiered. New York Undercover premiered. Party of Five premiered. It was also the debut of their incredible Thursday night lineup, Martin, Living Single, and New York Undercover. And The Simpsons returned to its original Sunday night lineup. Fox was killing it in 1994, in my opinion. And back when Fox was still good. So I'm not going to waste any more time. Let me show y'all the intro of New York Undercover, and then I'm going to get back watching the rest of this game. But that's going to wrap up my rant celebrating 30 years of New York Undercover premiering on Fox. We are 4 days away from the 30th anniversary of Party of Five. Like, comment, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell for my next rant, and I will see you after the game when I do a recap of yesterday's college football game between the Texas Longhorns and the Michigan Wolverines. Play stupid games, win stupid prizes, no more talk. Here is the intro to New York Undercover.